Honorable Vice Chancellor Dr. Abid Farid, Senior Director Middle East Africa Microsoft, Brother Haripur, colleagues from Microsoft, faculty members, colleagues from HEC, dear students, ladies and gentlemen, assalamu alaikum. It is an honor and a privilege for me to be here today. And I'm very pleased to be here today because I know when we started initial interaction with Microsoft and we thought we should be working together as not as a buyer and seller thing, that is a business venture only as a partner. And we are proud that in alhamdulillah in Pakistan in technology we are also with the help of our partner we are doing a pretty good job inshallah. And I was very impressed to see these demonstration by you and also the brothers. I wish I am again a student or teacher at least. As I always say, I never thought I was so bad professor, they pushed me in this clinical job. But anyway, ladies and gentlemen, this is good that in Pakistan, alhamdulillah, government is investing in this sector, higher education sector. As you are all aware that we started this journey in 2002 as HEC. This year we are celebrating our 15th year anniversary. The journey started with a very limited resources, with 59 universities, only 270,000+ students in the university system, only 800+ publication coming from Pakistan. Today, after 15 years, we have 188 universities, 1.4 million students in our university system. If we add the affiliated colleges part, the 3.1 million students are in higher education sector. But the bad news is that there are still 37 million people, around 37 million people in the age group of 17 to 23. They are looking for some options. They are looking for some opportunity that they should also get good education. Keeping in view the constraint, especially the faculty, I think this technology is providing us an opportunity that we should do something good at home even. And we are lucky that in Pakistan we created the Pakistan Education Research Network, the PERN. And we started building our system, mashallah, and today we are proud that we have a cloud computing system in Pakistan. With the capacity of 5,000 servers at the time available with HEC, we have worked with all our universities and our partners, different partners, including the Microsoft. And as the HEC team or Microsoft team was sharing with you the opportunities available to our youth, to our faculty, they are huge. But again, the bad news is we are not utilizing them. We are not efficiently utilizing them. I request to honorable Vice Chancellor and faculty to please make sure that we are getting benefit of these tools available. If required, you may try to create some learning opportunity for faculty even. I need to learn because these are new things. They were not there when I was doing my education or when I was teaching. So we should not be shy of learning. Every day it is a new learning. And we were told that learning is a continual process. And I think this is a good opportunity. And for youth, you have a huge opportunity. You can use it as a business tool. You can learn different these tools and you can make a lot of good resources for your family. Because nowadays creating jobs for people is a very difficult task for government. Don't look for job, create jobs. You should be job creator, not job seeker. That is the message for you, ladies and gentlemen. And the way technology is changing, I was talking with Brother Ro, that I think we might not need teachers in the next few years. The way artificial intelligence is moving, the machines are going to teach you. But we do need people who are going to teach machine what to do, teach to rest of the people. And that is the reason, ladies and gentlemen, in Pakistan also, we are setting up a center of excellence in big database, in cloud computing, in artificial intelligence, and all those new innovation coming in market. I think the biggest teacher or biggest innovator in the world at the moment is the Hollywood. Whatever 30 years back they were showing in the fiction movies, Today it is reality. So whenever I see today's fiction movies where they are showing the war of the new alien coming to this world, I get scared that this is going to be reality. Because I still remember when I was at school level or college level, this black and white TV started in Pakistan. They used to show some fiction movie where they were using those a guy who was a man from Uncle or something like that, Simon Temple and those type of thing. Roger Moore movie and other movies, they were showing that they are doing something and he's stuck somewhere. He's just opening his shoes and he's opening those things and then he's talking with the phone. And that was the time when we were thinking, how it is possible? The phone in the shoes and the phone in the watch. And today it is reality, ladies and gentlemen. I'm still just keeping my finger crossed that when this material science people, the physics people are going to make it reality, when in the Star Trek they say energize and the persons are shifted to another region in within no time. So at least we should be getting rid of this long traveling, 10-hour traveling and those type of thing. They should energize me from here to Morocco or from Morocco to somewhere else.
Space vector.
Space vector. Challenge for you, ladies and gentlemen, especially for students. This is your era, this is your world. Whatever these gray-haired people and the rest of the world they have done, and what we are enjoying with technology, you are going to create a new world for the next generation. Keep it balanced. Because another thing which is worrying me is the way technology is going ahead, we are becoming less and less human. We need to also create a balance in our societies. The human part we should not ignore. My biggest concern to my society and my education system is, especially to those internet companies and 3G's provider and other things, you have taken away the dreams of our youth. And of youth, they are not dreaming. You don't have a good future. What is happening today? That whole night, we just play games. We are working on WhatsApp and sending messages to each other. Jokes and every those, whatever, depending on your age. By the way, we should be very careful. Because now people are focusing on those messages and they are saying, what is in your telephone and what is in my telephone? Because you're so, but still, you know, I will suggest to parents and the student, please keep some time for yourself also. Turn off your mobiles after midnight. Have nice sleep. Get some dreams. Because without dreams, you cannot have future. As Martin Luther King, he used to say, I have a dream. So let's see how many people have dreams. Kisko khwab aate hain, zara haath khada karein. Still we have a hope. Still we have a hope. Let's dream for future. Let's dream for human. And all these tools are for human to facilitate your life, to facilitate our life. We should not take them that we have to facilitate technology. No, it is the other way around. So any research, any work you are doing, keep human part in front of you. But this should facilitate human part. And second important message is, it should have some constructive effect, not destructive effect. We have to make this world heaven, not the hell, which right now we are facing. I appreciate your time. I know today is Friday, I'm sorry I have to rush because I have another meeting I took you. Between this enjoyment, I was enjoying your lecture. So first thing I will ask my team to put this window tent on my laptop so that I can start enjoying it. Because after 5 months, I want to go back to teaching. So I will be using this tool to just impress my students. But they know better than us. I remember when I used to teach, that was the initial time when people were doing the PowerPoint. And I was also a student when I was in state. And I used to say to my teacher, I know from there you have borrowed these slides. This is on the such and such website. So people are smart now. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for your time. I will request Microsoft, I will request HEC to make this collaboration more effective. And I was told that you have some issue of, I think they are providing you 150, what those 150 vouchers. Yes, free vouchers. So I'm adding 300 more free vouchers. We have passed. Give them the opportunity to our youth so that they should come forward and utilize those resources. But to make this fruitful and effective, I think university teacher has to play their role. Have few sessions, even you can utilize Saturday, Sunday. Have some afternoon session for faculty, for student. Give them motivation so that they should be aware of this good opportunity and similar other opportunities so that they should come forward and utilize them. That is where government and people of Pakistan are investing for you. We are paying for that and we should get benefit of it. And I'm thankful to Microsoft because mashallah they brought a big team from different part of the world. I hope in next couple of decades we might be, you don't have to travel, take the midnight flight and it's a thought or anything. You just have to stand and say energize and you're there. Keep hope alive. Do go for dreams. And then inshallah the future will be bright. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. This opportunity, and you're the first university they are starting this thing, and inshallah we'll continue this process, brother. And but next time we should be checking out, we should be also with the screen line. I think you are showing those targets, how many in your presentation. So I think next time, like, we should have one line for Microsoft. We have achieved, so that should be also test case. Thank you very much.